Have you ever looked up in the night sky and wondered why you see the same spots on the moon every time? Why can't you see the moon any differently? What if the moon merely rotated? We here on Earth would be able to look up and see all sides of the moon, right? So let's add an arrow so to make the rotation of the moon more apparent. Note that as the moon rotates, the line goes from vertical to horizontal to vertical to horizontal and so forth. That means it's rotating. What if the moon didn't rotate and it only revolved around us like this? We would still be able to see all sides of the moon, right? See, the horizontal line remains the same. What if the moon both rotated and revolved like this? Look carefully and you will see, yes, we still get to have a 360 degree view of the moon, no hidden sides. But what if the moon rotated just as fast as it revolves like this? Oh, check this out. The moon is rotating, right? Look at the line if you don't believe me. Horizontal, vertical, right? But it's rotating at a rate that matches the revolution just so that only one side of the moon ever faces the Earth. And that's exactly the situation we find ourselves in today. The only side we ever see, we call the near side. The side we don't ever see, we call the far side. Actually, the first time we ever saw the far side was from photographs sent by a Russian lunar spacecraft in 1959. But no human ever saw the far side directly until the Apollo 8 mission in 1968. But why don't we here on Earth ever see the far side? Why does the moon spin exactly as fast as it revolves? We should spend weeks studying this one question, but I'll just give you the quick explanation. The near side of the moon experiences a significantly stronger gravitational field from Earth than does the far side. The moon's center of gravity is shifted towards Earth like this. If the moon rotated a bit faster or slower, the center of gravity would be lifted away from the Earth. And you know what happens when you lift something away from Earth? That's right, they're pulled back down to the Earth, which would align the moon right back to a position where the center of gravity is directly below the center of the mass. This is what prevents the moon from rotating any faster or slower than it does. The moon can only rotate so fast because Earth won't let it do otherwise. As a consequence, the moon rotates only once every revolution, and only one side of the moon ever faces us. The difference is in Earth's gravity as well as moon's gravity has other effects as well. For example, Earth's oceans are relatively easy to stretch as the Earth rotates and sea level goes up and down. As we pass under each bulge, we experience high tide twice a day because there are two bulges. But have you ever wondered why there are two bulges and why we have one bulge just opposite side of the Earth, farthest from the moon? You see, moon's gravity pulls the Earth everywhere. Closest point on Earth will have a greater pull, so the water bulges out. But moon also pulls the Earth towards it, and the furthest point is also pulled ever so slightly. And that's why we have two bulges on opposite side of the Earth. You can also see that sometimes the bulges are more high than other times. And this happens every 7 days or so. As of now, we are only talking about the effect of moon. Let's now bring in the big brother sun into the picture, shall we? You see, when sun, moon and earth lines up in one line, the combined gravitational pull is stronger on the Earth's ocean surface. So we see very high bulges and we call it spring tide. And when the Sun, Moon and Earth makes a 90 degree angle, the gravitational pull of the Sun nullifies some of the effect of the Moon's pull. So we see somewhat diminished bulges and we call it a neap tide. So how will you know when is neap tide and when is spring tide? Look at the Moon. If it is a full moon or no moon, then it will be spring tide. And if you see a half moon, then it will be a neap tide. Right? I did this entire animation on PowerPoint. You can too if you give this video a thumbs up and subscribe. So next time you look up at the night sky, remember the little science you learned today.